हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हम स्टार्ट करने जा रहे हैं इलस्ट्रेशन वन सीएमए फाइनल एसएफएम फॉरेन एक्सचेंज एंड रिस्क मैनेजमेंट। ओके, इन दिस क्वेश्चंस वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द एक्सचेंज रेट बिटवीन डीजी एंड पाउंड्स। व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन? प्लीज रीड द क्वेश्चंस वंस। प्लीज, एक्चुअली अ कस्टमर व्हिच हैज टू पे होलैंड, व्हिच हैज टू पे होलैंड, करेंसी ऑफ होलैंड इज डीजी, रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ डीजी 12,50,000 होलैंड करेंसी, बट ड्यू टू द बैंक स्ट्राइक, ड्यू टू बैंक स्ट्राइक द बैंक इज नॉट एबल टू पे डीजी 2,50,000 ऑन 25th March। सेम करेंसी बैंक विल पे ऑन 2nd April, 2nd April। नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन व्हाट इज द गेन और लॉस, गेन और लॉस ड्यू टू नॉट पेमेंट ऑन 25th March एंड ड्यू टू पेमेंट ऑफ 2nd April। ओके, नाउ द कस्टमर, इट इज नॉट गिवेन द कस्टमर ऑफ व्हिच करेंसी कंपनी, व्हिच कंट्री, इट इज अज्यूम्ड एज अ इंडियन क्वेश्चन, इट इज अज्यूम कस्टमर इंडियन कस्टमर, दिस इज द इंडियन कस्टमर। नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, इंडियन कस्टमर हैव टू पे होलैंड करेंसी, देयर मस्ट बी रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन रुपीज एंड होलैंड, होलैंड दैट इज नॉट गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, दैट इज नॉट गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन। नाउ यू हैव टू फाइंड, दैट इज नॉट रुपीज एंड डीजी व्हिच इज नॉट गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन। नाउ यू हैव टू फाइंड relationship between rupees and dg by using this exchange rate. Other things, what in the questions, in the dollar per 100 rupees is given, dollar per 100 rupees is given in the questions, dollar per 100, it is not given for single rupee or single dollar, $1 for 100 rupees is exchange rate is given. You need to calculate in this case rupees per dollar, rupees per dollar. And other thing, the bank wishes to retain the exchange margin. Exchange margin is 0.25. How much does the customer extend to gain or loss due to the delay? That I am asking to you. Okay. In these questions, please try to understand what is required. First, you have to calculate working note first. Calculation of exchange rate between rupees and dollar in real terms. Okay, the rupees 100 per dollar, how can you write just opposite of this by reversing this? 1 upon 2.8 2.29 2962, 1 upon 2.2873, rupees per dollar, rupees per dollar, number of rupees is, how can you write rupees per dollar, 100 divided by 2.2962, 100 divided by 2.2873, like this. This was dollar per 100 rupees. Now 100 rupees per dollar is divided, this will go by this side, this will go by this side, you will have to do like this. Okay, the on what you will write, rupees per dollar is 100 divide 2.2962, this will be 43.5502. Now divide 2.2873, 43.7196. This is the exchange rate. Now you have to calculate exchange rate between rupees and DG, rupees and DG on 25th March. Look at it. Working note. Second, calculation of exchange rate rupees per DG at 25th March 2015, 2015. Okay, now rupees per dollar you have is calculated. What is calculated? 43.55 0.2. This is a 0.2. Okay. Now, other relation is given here. Dollar per pound. Here, this is the one. Okay. Dollar per pound is, what is the relation? 1.9120, 1.9135. This is the second. Now, other relation is DG per pound 4.1125. DG per pound is 4.1125, 4.1135, 40. Now your target to calculate rupees per DG. How to calculate? In this case, you have to eliminate dollar, you have to eliminate pound, you have to eliminate dollar and pound from first and second. What can you write here? Rupees per dollar, dollar per pound. How can you write? This will be the rupees per pound is 43.5502 into 1.1920 minus this is the between 43.7196 into 1.9135. Okay, now these are rupees per pound. Now you have to calculate. What you have to calculate? You have to calculate rupees per DG. DG should be in unit currency. This should be in upper. So in this case, pound you have to eliminate. To pound eliminate one, in one quotation it should be in upward side, in other quotation it should be in downward side. But in third and fourth, in both cases pound is in downward side. That's why from third you can write pound per DG is 1 divided by 4.1140, 1 divided by 4.1125. This is the 5. From 4th and 5, what can you write it? Look at it. Rupees per pound, pound per DG equal to rupees per DG is 43.5502, 1.1920 divided by 4.1140. 43.7196 1.9135 44.1125 exchange rate would be, please try to understand here, 43.5502 into 1.1920 divide 4.1140, then it will be 12.6183. In the next case, 43.7196 into 1.9135 divide 4.1125, then 20.19. This is a 91. This is a 91. This is a 91. 20.3422. This is the 91. Okay. Now, into 1.9120 divide 4.1140 20.2401. This is your exchange rate. Now, please try to understand, what is your exchange rate? Rupees per DG is 20.2401, and this is your bid rate. Similarly, you can calculate your ask rate here. Ask rate is already here, 20.3422. Now, Indian company have to purchase this currency and bank will sell. What will be the applicable rate? This will be the applicable rate. Applicable rate for purchase, applicable rate for purchase DG 20.3422 per rupees per DG. Exchange margin, bank exchange margin, what is the bank exchange margin is also given in the question, that is the 0.025%. Hence, net rate to purchase DG 1 equal to rupees 20.3422, 1 plus 0.0025. It is 20.3930. Now, actually customer have to buy DG 12,50,000 20.3930 into 12,50,000, then rupees it would be 54,91,250 rupees. He will have to pay this much amount on 25th March. But he paid in a 1st April, exactly the same way you have to calculate on 1st April, okay? And thereafter you find the difference between these two, and that will be the gain or loss, okay? In the same way, we have to calculate on 2nd of rail. Look at it. Rupees per dollar, you write here, rupees per dollar, in this case, each 100 divided by, you must write it, okay? Divide by what? 2.3063. Look at it. 3,159. Then what will be this? Rupees. In the rupees per dollar. Rupees per dollar each, in this case, what will happen? 100 divide 2.3159, 43.1797, 100 divide 2.3063, 43.3594. This year again you assume first. Now what rates are given here in this case? In the second case, dollar per pound is given. Dollar per pound each. What is the rate? 1.9050, 1.9070. Now, DG per pound 4.0120. DG per pound is 4.0130. This is assumed second, this is assumed on third. Now you have to calculate relation between rupees and DG. You try to understand. You have to calculate these relations. Now think which one currency you have to eliminate. You have to eliminate two currency. One is a pound and other is a dollar. So now from first and second, what can you write? Rupees per dollar. Dollar per pound. Here rupees per pound is 43.1719 divide 2.3159. 43.1797. This is your 7. 91797 into 1.9050. 43.3594 into 1.9070. Now this is assumed fourth. Okay. Now from third and fourth, in these two, third and fourth. No, from third only. Pound per digit. Why I am doing like this? Because we have to eliminate pound. We have to calculate these. The pound one should be in indirect code, other should be in direct code. Once it is a downside, other should be in upside. In the case fourth, it was in downside. In the case of third, it was in downside. That's why you must have to bring upside one. So here DG you have to bring in downside. That's why I changed this. Okay. Each, what will happen here? 1 divided by 4.0130. 1 divided by 4.0120. This is a 5. Now from 4th and 5. Rupees per pound. Pound per DG, rupees per DG is 43.1797, 1.9050 whole divided by 4.0130. Similarly, 43.3594 into 1.9070 divided by 4.0120. Rupees per DG is, look at it, 43.1797 into 1.9050 divide 4.0130. This is 20.4977. Now next, 43.3594 into 1.9070 divide 4.0120. 20.6097, that this is the equation. Okay, what, look at it, rupees per DG is 20.6097, 4977. Look at it. You have to purchase here. You have to purchase in this case DG 12,50,000. The rate, what will be the rate? DG 1, you have to buy. The bank will sell. Bank will sell. Then high rate, this rate will be applicable. Rupees 20.6097. Actual rate will be, because of the bank exchange margin, actual rate ड्यू टू बैंक एक्सचेंज मार्जिन, एक्सचेंज मार्जिन DG1 इक्वल टू रुपीज 20.6097 वन प्लस 0.0025 20.6097 इंटू 1.0025 दिस इज DG1 इक्वल टू रुपीज 20.6612 DG 12,50,000 रुपीज 12,50,000 इंटू 20.6612 इंटू 12,50,000 2,58,26,530. तो व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू पे ऑन 2 अप्रैल इन प्लेस ऑफ 12,50,000 यू हैव टू पे दिस मच अमाउंट. दिस इज द फॉर 2 अप्रैल. ओके, एंड व्हाट वाज द 15th अप्रैल, 15th मार्च, डीजी 12,50,000 इक्वल टू, यू हैव ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेटेड, यू हैव ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेटेड 15th मार्च. व्हाट वाज दिस? ऑन 15th मार्च यू हैव कैलकुलेटेड 12,58,000. On 15th March, 54,091, 2,54,091, 54,91,250. Okay, please try to understand. Same amount when you had paid on 2nd April, equivalent rupees was this. On the 15th March, equivalent rupees was this. The loss due to delay, bank strike, what will be the loss due to bank strike? You had to calculate this, the difference between these. In place of this amount, you have to pay this much amount on 2nd April. So this, the difference between these two, what will be the difference between these two? 254,91,250, 335,280. 335,280. This is your loss. Loss due to bank strike. This is the amount loss due to exchange. Look at it, was a very, very easy question. You had to payment on 15th March. Due to bank strike, you have to pay on 2nd April. Then you have to find the what is the loss or gain due to the 15th March bank strike. So you calculated in rupees term equivalent DG 12,50,000 on 15th March and 2nd April, and find the difference. You will have calculated net loss due to bank strike. That is the answer. 12 lakh total loss, 3,38,000 is written here, 344 as per your book, but I have calculated here. Look at, due to the bank, there may be some point ignored in the answer of this because of it is taken 2 points. I have taken 4 points. That's why our answer will be correct. Okay, this is the way of calculating this question. This is the one of the most important question in each and every professional exam. This questions has been asked to you. Okay, thank you, class.